Welcome back to Daytime York Region. We're pleased to welcome with us author Ned Levitt. Ned, you're not only an author, you wrote the book about your daughter and the loss of her and the grieving process.
Right.
Jeremy and I both read the book, and we already feel like we know Stacy, your daughter, and yourself. But tell us about who Stacy is.
Well, Stacy, I have three daughters. Stacy is my middle daughter, but she died in August 30th, 1995, when she went out for a jog, and she was struck by a car at Ledbury and Lawrence. Mm-hmm. And it destroyed my world for a very long time. But ultimately, I realized that there was no way out of this but really to go through the pain. And then I started to look to Stacy and what she left behind for us, which was her wonderful, inspiring poetry. And her spirit and her poetry actually started to help me heal and get back to life again.
There's so many questions, and it was a very difficult read, both not only your book, but we could both kind of got to know Stacy through your books and through Stacy's book of poetry. How do you start getting through that grief? Yeah. Where do you begin on a journey like that?
Well, anything that comes into our life to crush us has the potential to end not only our lives, because suicide is a consequence of these difficult things. I contemplated suicide initially, never had been suicidal in my life, never been depressed, but it is a consequence of this amount of pain. But what you start to realize and that you have to take meaning from what happened or make meaning. In my case, there was nothing to learn from. This is just a silly accident that shouldn't have happened. So I started to throw myself into bereavement work when I realized that I was starting to heal. I started to devour books about loss and to learn more about it. And as I did, because I'm a lawyer, I've studied my whole life, and I became fascinated by the area. And I started to give back to other people. And I found that I could, and especially because I used Stacy's story and Stacy's poetry and her spirit, that's what helps people who are, you know, earlier on their journey than mm-hmm. I was. So I started to make meaning out of the loss. And by trying to make, the more I made meaning, the more I healed, the better it was for me. So I guess where you start is to try to find something out of the trauma. If you're a recovering alcoholic, help other recovering alcoholics. It is hugely healing to reach out to other people.
Now, in your personal journey, when Stacy, the night that this happened,
sure.
She was out on a jog.
Right.
Now, and she also previously climbed a mountain in Mexico. Well, she got halfway up.
She tried
to climb Mount Ixta.
Right.
And it was canceled because of bad weather.
Right.
Now you, after this happened, you changed your life around and you started exercising, and you would run Stacy's run.
Right.
The path that she took.
Right.
And you also climbed Mount Ixta.
Right.
And it seems to me that you were carrying her on your shoulders. Right. And kind of finishing off some of the things that she wanted to do.
Yeah, I mean, we live in a death-denying culture, so and a lot of myths exist around loss, and particularly loss of children, which is the most difficult loss in any culture at any time in our history. So one of the myths is that after a year I would be feeling better, but in fact after a year I was feeling worse. It is a lot longer process than that. And there are some patterns of grieving, gender patterns, and many men need to grieve by doing. So 14 months after I lost Stacy, I had her book. It was a picture of her on that mountain. She journaled. I knew that she had tried with this group of girls from Bishop Strong Collegiate to climb the mountain. They got turned back by weather. And in her writing, she said how much she wanted to complete the climb. And then it hit me. I had to finish her unfinished business. So with my brother Frank and four Outward Bound instructors, 14 months after the accident, we took the Mount Ixta for her. And as an afterthought, I felt I had to leave something behind, and I realized I have to leave her book behind for others to read.
Mm-hmm.
So I had a box made, an all-weather box, chained it to a spot about a third of the way up the mountain, which is tough to get to, but the harder climb is after that. And I didn't know if it was going to be there a day or a week or whatever. 8 years later, from the time I did that, to this day, I'm getting back notepads full of messages and poems and drawings, everything imaginable from people who climbed that mountain and come across her poetry.
Unbelievable. The inspiring part about this tale is not only that you've gone through this process, which is a mountain to climb in its own right, but then decided to help other people. How did you go about putting together your book?
Well, I've done a lot of publishing in my practice.
As a lawyer.
As a lawyer and business books. So I enjoy the writing process. But actually, the book had, there's so many reasons for writing the book. One is that journaling is a very, very healing thing to do whenever you're going through difficult times. A lot of people do it just sort of instinctively. Mm-hmm. But sometimes we counsel the bereaved parents, you know, write a journal. It doesn't matter if no one is ever going to read it. It's actually very therapeutic. So that was my journaling therapy as well. But also, I'm a very extroverted person. I like to tell my story. There's a degree of frustration. There's so much to tell here. I want people to know about Stacy, the journey, about my climb. I found it frustrating to get it out, even in a whole evening with people. So it became a very logical thing to do it in a book. And I wrote the book because I wanted to. And I also had an intention of touching other people, of helping other people who are going through difficult times. I was not prepared, I must tell you, with the reaction to this book. I'm still trying to figure it out. It was launched in September, and I'm overwhelmed with the amount of interest in the book.
And you talk often in the book about people, parents and other people's reactions to, as one person you introduce in the book, a club that you would never want to join.
Right.
But you take this relief in other people being part of the club.
Yeah, there's a very important saying in the bereavement community that grief shared is grief diminished. And that's a very important part of the principle. One of the things I do, among many, is to facilitate bereavement groups for bereaved parents. And that is absolutely one of the basic principles in how we help them, is we come together as a group. So you feel less like a victim. You're able to let your hair down and be who you really are. Because unfortunately, when you're, for example, a bereaved parent, you don't feel like you fit into the greater culture because no one really understands what you're going through.
Right.
When you're with a room full of other bereaved parents, then they understand.
We also have a website that people can go to,
right.
iamarose.com, and that has Stacy's, some of her published poems
right.
in there. I want to know what you are reclaiming and what you are regaining now in your life after the years of grieving.
Well, there's sort of literature out there on the loss of children, and there's a couple of themes that stand out in my mind. One of them is that when your child dies, they give you a gift. If you can take it. And another theme is that you have to establish a new relationship with your deceased child. I'm a living, walking example of those two things. I have enormous gifts that Stacy has left me. And
Stacy is a beautiful gift in herself,
yeah.
in her own right.
An amazing story, a wonderful story. Of course, the books, check out iamarose.com, and for more information. It was very inspirational to speak to you. Simply not only reading the book, but just meeting you in person, and it made us feel better and... I really do miss Stacy.
Okay.
I've never met her, but sounded wonderful.
Thank you.
I'm
very
sorry
much.
For your loss. I'm Arose.com. Coming up, we're talking Phil Entertainment with Phil Martino next on Daytime New York Region.